iOS 18.2 is now out for everyone, and there are some big new features. Not only does Apple Intelligence get a huge boost with new visual intelligence features, ChatGPT integration, Image Wand, Playgrounds, and more, but there are lots of features outside Apple Intelligence, like natural language search in music and TV, scrub frame by frame in videos, get a live activity when you're downloading a file, share item locations in Find My, some upgrades to podcasts, and more. Also, if you've been waiting for Apple Intelligence in localized English, it's now come to the UK, Australia, Canada, and several more English-speaking countries. More languages should be coming next year in 2025. And I'll be covering any new changes right here, so make sure you get subscribed. So before we get into the Apple Intelligence features, let's look at natural language search in Apple Music and TV. Now, instead of just searching for artists, albums, or genres, you can ask it things like electronic music without words, and we'll actually show you results based on that. Or you can search for classical music with singers. I'm not sure What a Wonderful World counts as classical, but you get the idea. In the same way, you can search for things like actors and different genres in the TV app. So you could search for something like Denzel Washington and see their movies, or even something like Denzel Washington with Dakota, and I might have forgotten her last name, but that movie result comes up right there at the top. Dakota Fanning is what I meant. You can also ask it for things like action movies with an actor or actress. You can include the genre and their name. You can even do multiple actors' names with a genre, like comedy with Julia Roberts and Cameron Diaz, and My Best Friend's Wedding comes up first. All right, now let's get into visual intelligence, because there's been huge upgrades since the early betas of 18.2. First of all, if you're at a business location or a point of interest, activate visual intelligence by holding on the camera control button on any iPhone 16 model. Then if you're in front of a business or place of interest, you'll actually see some information right on screen before having to use the Google or ChatGPT search. And what I have found, it's basically showing you maps information, so if there's like a menu or order that you would normally see in Apple Maps, you'll see it right here on the visual intelligence screen. If you tap something like menu, it will probably throw you over to the Yelp app or Open Table if you're booking a reservation, but nice to see more information here on the visual intelligence screen without having to use ChatGPT and Google. But I've also found multiple improvements for different kinds of data. So here I actually have a concert program, and let's try visual intelligence like they did in the demo at the keynote. I'm gonna point it here at a future concert, which has a date and time. I'll tap the snap picture button, and then you'll see the date pop up right here. I wish it would pull more information, like maybe put this text in a note, but I can tap on that date and then add the event to my calendar because it recognized the text in that photo. By the way, my wife is the principal flutist in the Lakeland Symphony Orchestra. She's kind of a big deal. Now, if you scan something like a business card or just something that has address, phone number, and websites, then visual intelligence is actually going to pull that out automatically. So you won't have to go to ChatGPT or Google, but you can call, visit a website, all right here from the screen. And if I hit the three dots, you also see some other options like read aloud and summarize. And there's the address as well. And that summarized text is actually pretty cool. It will even work on long passages of text. This is one of my favorite books, The Elements of Eloquence. And if I open visual intelligence, take a picture of a page, it's actually going to OCR that text, and I can tap summarize right here. And using Apple Intelligence is going to give me a summary of the text that I just scanned. And while you could do something like this before by just taking a picture and using the iPhone's OCR feature, it's nice to be able to do this just with one tap here in Visual Intelligence. Now, it's also really good at recognizing web URLs. So if I take a picture of the back of this box, which has multiple websites, you'll see they show up right here in Visual Intelligence, and I can tap the three dots and see all the websites one tap to visit it. This should be useful when you have business cards you need to scan as well, but I find it doesn't recognize the .fm domain just yet. You actually have to tap ask or search. Also, it really doesn't like identifying things like artwork, plants, and animals. You have to use one of these buttons, and that's Ask ChatGPT, or you can do a reverse Google image search. If you tap Ask, it's going to send the image to ChatGPT, and you'll usually get a good description of what you're looking at. I imagine artwork and other identification will be coming soon, because if you take a photo of something and you go to the Photos app, you can tap the eye icon, and artwork is something that you can look up right here, and Apple Photos will just tell you what it is to the best of its knowledge, and also give you some Siri suggested websites. I also found that when identifying plants, visual intelligence would not tell me what it is right away. I either had to prompt a reverse Google image search or search ChatGPT. I would typically get a good answer there, but if I just took a regular photo, went to the Photos app on my iPhone, it would tell me the name of the plant in that visual lookup feature. In the same way, you can even do laundry tag icons, and Apple Photos will tell you what it is, but visual intelligence will not. Over the course of the betas, I've seen more of these features come to visual intelligence, so I think as we go into 2025, visual intelligence will get even more powerful over time. And last thing with visual intelligence, one of the demos was identifying a dog breed, and visual intelligence just doesn't seem to do that yet. I can do Ask ChatGPT or do a reverse Google image search, search, and I'll usually get the answer, but it would be nice to see it right here without having to search external sources. All right, next up is the two-stage camera control shutter. If you go to settings, once you've updated to iOS 18, you can go to camera and then camera control here at the top, and you can enable autofocus and exposure lock with a light touch on camera control. And then once you're in the camera, you can do a light touch and it will lock autofocus and exposure. And then you can move the frame around and it will keep focus on that part of the frame. I still find the light touch to be a little finicky. I wish there was more haptic feedback on it. I basically have to look on screen to see when I'm triggering it. You can also disable that and just choose to have a clean preview on a light touch. And you can also choose a double click to open the camera from camera control if you want. Frankly, I'm gonna open Halide with camera control because I have lots of other shortcuts to the actual camera app. And now when I press it, it'll open the Halide app instead of the stock camera. Next, a big addition to Apple Intelligence in 18.2 is the addition of ChatGPT integration. If you go to Settings and then Apple Intelligence, you can scroll down and here we have ChatGPT integration. You don't have to have a ChatGPT account or even sign into your account, and you'll still be able to use the features. But if you want things like image generation without limits and use your ChatGPT Plus features, you can sign into your account here in Settings. You can also sign up for ChatGPT Plus right here in Settings. And one thing you'll probably want to toggle off is the Confirm ChatGPT Requests. If this is on, every time you ask the assistant, write a haiku about being a tech podcast creator. You're actually going to have to choose Use ChatGPT when this is toggled on. But if I toggle this off and do the same request, write a haiku about being a tech podcast creator. Then it will use ChatGPT automatically and you don't have to manually confirm it. There's a little haiku for you. Now, any request from the voice assistant that it can't do on its own, it will call to ChatGPT. What's the average rainfall in the Amazon basin? Something like that it will do on its own without asking ChatGPT. But if you ask it, write a sonnet about being a tech podcast creator in Florida during the winter. Then it will use ChatGPT to write you a sonnet. Now, you can actually prompt it to use ChatGPT from the beginning, because if you ask it to generate an image of a knight riding a polar bear, photorealistic. It's actually just going to do an image search rather than using ChatGPT to generate the image. But you can prompt it by starting with, using ChatGPT, generate an image of a medieval knight riding a polar bear into battle. And now it will actually use ChatGPT to generate that using AI rather than just an image search. So if you ever want to use ChatGPT rather than the built-in assistant, just start with the words, using ChatGPT, what's the average rainfall in the Amazon basin? And then it will default to using ChatGPT rather than the built-in assistant. So you can basically have your voice assistant use ChatGPT every time if you start with those words. Now, another place you'll see ChatGPT integration is in the writing tools for Apple Intelligence. So here I've actually added an audio file to Apple Notes, which will automatically transcribe and summarize it. But I'm going to add the transcript to the note. And now we can select the text. I'm going to select all of it, which is a lot because it's a full podcast transcript. And if I open the Apple Intelligence writing tools, not only do you have the proofread, rewrite, and the tools you had in previous versions, but you have the ChatGPT prompt window. So if you actually ask it to generate something like write a one paragraph intro to this podcast episode, now it's going to go ahead and actually use ChatGPT to compose. I do have to confirm it here, so I'll tap use ChatGPT. And then it will generate some new text, something that Apple Intelligence wouldn't do before. And there we have an intro now written by ChatGPT, not just Apple Intelligence. You can also use ChatGPT in the writing tools to generate text from nothing. Write me a bedtime story about a medieval knight and a polar bear rescuing a princess from a dragon. And with that kind of prompt, now I can choose Use ChatGPT, and it will write me that bedtime story, which Apple Intelligence wouldn't do before. And there's the full bedtime story. I'll have to read that later. To be honest, the ChatGPT integration for Apple Intelligence actually makes it way more useful because it's basically ChatGPT in more places and easier to access. But let's look at another update in 18.2 that's all Apple Intelligence, and that's Image Wand and Image Playgrounds. So for Image Wand, I'm actually going to go to Apple Notes, and let's say I wanted to create an image of something like a pyramid. Well, I can actually just write the word here with the Apple Pencil, and then when I go up to the tools, I can choose the Image Wand right here, circle the word that I had written, and it will generate an image based on what I just wrote. These features, I believe, are coming to the iWork suite as well, and this is going to be more useful in something like Keynote when you're making slides and just want to pull an image. Now, these pyramids are not very photorealistic, so the other thing you can do, rather than actually write and circle a word, I can select text here in Notes, and you see all these options here. I still think this needs to be redesigned so it's easier to navigate, but you can go to Add to Playground. This is a little different than in earlier betas, and if I tap Add to Playground, now it will generate an image based on the text that I had selected. Now we have a little bit more realistic image of the pyramids. I can tap done, and now I have this image that I can move around my Apple Note, resize it, and it actually does increase in resolution like I discovered in my last video, I'll link it above, when you resize it here in the Note. And that works for any text you select here in Notes. So I'll select 18.2, add to Playground, and let's see what it comes up with. You heard it here first. There's the iPhone 17 Air. Also, if you have a lot of text in a document, like this is a full transcript of my podcast, Primary Technology with Jason A10, you should totally subscribe above, watch it here on YouTube. I can actually go to the Image Wand tool, tap that, and I'll just circle down here below the transcript, and it's actually gonna try and pull from all the text above. And as you can see, it was too much text, so it won't do it. Let me try with something with a little less text. I'll just circle in that blank spot at the bottom. It'll try to pull text from the note above, and that's what it has to represent. Shortcuts. Okay, cool. Now, in addition to Image Wand, you also have Image Playgrounds. You'll probably have to request access to Image Playgrounds, and at least in the beta cycle, the wait was pretty lengthy, but here you can generate horrifying avatars of yourself and your friends. Here's me cartoon-like as a doctor in the mountains, or illustrated, or me holding corn dogs. Now, in Image Playgrounds, you can just tap the plus at the bottom, and here you can choose a photo of someone, either yourself or someone in your camera roll, and it will just automatically generate images of that person. And then you can tap some of the suggestions here to change the image, and then place yourself in a different location or genre. But you can also write down here, me riding a polar bear dressed as a medieval knight. Will it do it? Yeah, I guess that's me as a medieval knight, but no polar bear in sight. I've found that it doesn't like to generate full body images of people. It really just tries to do from the shoulders up, but you can play around and it's a fun party trick, especially making other people look like AI avatars. But what you'll probably use more is Genmoji. So now when you're in your messages, you can tap the emoji picker and choose one of your normal boring emojis, or you can tap this icon right here, and now you can generate whatever you'd like. A knight riding a polar bear. Apparently it heard mouse riding a Vespa, but let's try again. Banana surfing next to an island. And you can create a banana surfing next to an island. I did an even more in-depth video on visual intelligence in Genmoji, and again, you can link that above, and I'll put it in the description as well. Now, there are a bunch more features outside of Apple Intelligence in 18.2. For instance, if you go into your Photos app and you're trying to edit a video, you can now scrub frame by frame. Just hold your finger on the timeline for a second, and now you can scrub basically frame by frame for really accurate edits. Also, when you're downloading a file, you'll get a live activity on your lock screen. So if I tap download, you'll actually see that live activity right here letting you know when it's finished. And yes, I was downloading an episode of my tech podcast, Primary Tech. Did I mention you should subscribe to that? Also, there's been improvements to the Voice Memos app. Let's say you recorded a melody or yourself humming and you actually want to add a second track. Well, now when you go to a voice memo recording, you can tap the plus icon here and you can actually record something on top of the first track. You can replace what was recorded or start recording something new, and Voice Memos will actually overlay it, and then you can import this into GarageBand or Logic and actually have a multi-track file. There's also a cool interface for seeing both tracks. There's the second track I recorded and the original, and you can even choose to separate the layers and create multiple files. Find My has also been updated to share items with other people. So in addition to sharing the AirTag with someone permanently, you can go down to the Lost AirTag section, tap Show Item Location, and now you can actually share a link with someone. Apparently you actually have to lose the item first, but then you'll be able to share this even with things like brands or airlines so they can find your luggage. iOS 18.2 now brings those mail categories like promotions and priority. That should be available on your iPhone, iPad, and your Mac. And finally, Apple Podcasts actually got a little bit of love here. When you actually go to your library section and go to categories, this has been redesigned, letting you know how many shows you have in each category. You can tap manage and then actually set categories as favorites. Then you can just start playing episodes from that category or jump in and see shows that you follow and also get recommendations of other shows in the same category. And of course you can go to the top shows and, oh, what's that right there? Did I tell you about? Okay, never mind. The search page has also been updated and you can go to specific categories like the tech again. And it's gonna try and tailor those results with your favorite categories and show you results both from your library and help you discover new shows. So those are big changes with iOS 18.2, but get subscribed because there'll be more updates coming soon. And we still don't really have a smarter SIRI, if you know what I mean. The voice assistant is supposed to get more contextually aware and semantic index with your information. And that should be coming next year in 2025. So like I said, get subscribed, hit that like button. If you have any questions on 18.2, leave a comment below this video. And if you're just updating to iOS 18 and you want to see all the features, I did a video of 95 plus new features in iOS 18, even outside Apple Intelligence. You can check that out up here. And if you're watching this during the holiday season and you're looking for last minute tech gift ideas, I have a video right here with a gift starting at just $10, and it's tech I actually use, not just stuff I'm suggesting. It's what I use every day at home, travel, and for work. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.